Hey, shattered windows, stained carpeting, hair all over the church pews. A local church is broken into by a most unusual visitor.
The whole thing didn't last long, but the pastors got the whole thing on camera. News Channel 3's Chris Yu shows us what happened in Sturgis.
I heard banging.
An intruder breaks through this church window.
I yelled to my husband, "They're still here!"
Pastors Amanda and Luke Eicher weren't sure what would happen next.
He turned the light on and was just shocked.
But then the intruder reveals himself.
Oh my word!
A 10-point buck finds sanctuary at Grace Church in Sturgis on the opening day of the firearm deer season.
No, don't go up there!
That's where we have our computers and soundboard, and I thought
all
he's gonna
equipment.
Just tear everything up. So my focus was to get him back downstairs.
Which the buck did do before climbing out the window he came in.
Yes!
I was a little sad that we didn't actually take a little time to pray with him, you know, before he went out to face the world on the opening day of deer season.
The buck cut himself on the glass, but otherwise appeared to be okay. Other than some stains and scuffs, the church is fine as well.
The deer was a gentleman.
Since the Eichers posted their video online, it's gone viral, getting the attention of news outlets all over the country.
Never for a million years did I think that the video would explode the way it has.
But what the Eichers love the most is the joy the video brings.
Nice to have a reason to laugh.
Yeah, I hope it brings a smile to people's faces. We needed it, and hopefully other people can also, you know, have a good chuckle as well.
The Eichers are in the process of getting their carpet clean. Now, as for why this bug jumped into that church, the Eichers say that's still the biggest mystery.
Well, if you look around the skies in West Michigan, you'll likely see a pilot in training, pilots that could be taking you on your next trip.
All right, you have the flight controls again.
To become a pilot,
you can't learn how to fly without actually doing it.
You have to learn firsthand how to fly.
And I'm right here?
Yeah.
So I boarded the plane and buckled into the pilot seat.
Keep turning until I say stop. Let go.
To get a look at WMU's classroom in the sky.
And Sky Bronco 43 is going to make a left turn head north by Gull Lake.
What football field is that down there? Do you know?
That's Northern, Portage Northern.
Before students in WMU's program take off.
For the turbine engines, it's not like that.
Their work starts in the classroom.
There is a lot of studying that goes into it and a lot of memorization there, but it is really unlike anything else.
A senior, Shane Rembold, is following in his father's footsteps to become a pilot.
There is tremendous growth forecast for the aviation industry.
To match the jump in enrollment, the university has moved the program into a $24 million facility at the Battle Creek Executive Airport at Kellogg Field.
State-of-the-art aircraft really prepare our students well for the industry.
The new building includes 13 classrooms and a handful of flight simulators.
Every button, every switch, it's identical to what you would see in the front end of an actual airliner.
Over the last 10 years, enrollment has soared 80%.
Pull back just a little bit, nice and easy.
With more than 800 students in the pilot program right now, WMU has pushed back first takeoff until most students are in their sophomore year. My co-pilot and flight instructor, Jim Whittle, says it could take another year or two before graduates can take off and fly for a major airline.
I'm going to take you back and do a landing.
All right, let's do it.
What I want to do is get right over the runway and try to fly at 1 foot above the ground. Airplane's power is all the way out. I'm just going to hold it off till it won't fly anymore and it touches down.
Woo!
And it was truly an incredible experience getting to actually see and experience that hands-on learning that comes with their training. The university also offers career pathway programs here to set students up for a job working for a major airline like United and Delta. Sometimes they're recruiting the students here as early as their freshman year.
A fire at the VFW in Kalamazoo destroys dozens of Thanksgiving meals for families in need.
Yeah, the turkeys that were going to be shipped out have all burned in the fire. News Channel 3's Tricia McCauley is joining us live in studio to let us know what's being done to put together meals for local veterans this Thanksgiving. Tricia.
Yeah, Andy and Erica, just take a look at the fire. It burned the entire kitchen, and unfortunately, that's where the Thanksgiving meals were being stored that the VFW was hoping to give to families in need.
Disbelief was the feeling, sadness, anger. It was a combination of things. Could have been far worse.
The Kalamazoo Department of Public Safety says an officer on patrol spotted smoke coming from the VFW on Kilgore Road early Sunday morning.
And they've always tried to protect our post, and it was on one of those patrols where the fire was spotted early enough to at least enclose it within the kitchen for the worst part.
VFW Post 1527 leaders say it was an electrical fire in the ceiling. They say the majority of the damage was in the kitchen, where unfortunately the VFW was keeping Thanksgiving meals for West Michigan families in need.
We were gathering, we had everything together for meals for vet families or families that may need a meal. For Thanksgiving, it was all going to be ready for them to pick up or to be delivered to them so they could cook it at their house and everything like that. Unfortunately, the fire destroyed all of it.
There is a silver lining. Commander John Carter says they lost a lot of meals in the fire, but 9 turkeys were in a post member's freezer and were saved. 2 community members have since stepped up to get the rest of the supplies, and Meyer donated a $100 gift card to replace what was lost. Carter says they can now give the 11 families they had promised Thanksgiving meals.
The commander tells me they did lose 20 to 30 turkeys they were saving to give away for Christmas, but he says they still have plenty of time to rebuild that supply.